Greetings, fellow things. Welcome back to Delta Force 2. We are continuing with Operation Common Resolve, and our next objective is Mission Special Delivery. Now, we do have another choice of going on a power trip, but unfortunately, I do believe this takes priority for the time being, since it actually involves the virus, you know, the package of viruses, the stolen package of viruses. Now, how we got this information, I have no idea. Maybe it was intercepted from some sort of communications. Maybe it was, well, we got it when we raided Blindside. But one of the downsides of disabling enemy communications is that SIGINT will not be able to work as intended. I mean, it'll have far less information to go on. But anyway, I suppose that's a price to pay for making the enemy more disorganized. At least now that we have an enemy, have a face to put to the enemy. Anyhow, so yeah, for this mission, the stolen virus package has been split into several shipments. Locate the package at Objective Mamba and secure it. Now, another thing that I'm doing right now is I'm actually fiddling with my settings, my OBS settings. I noticed that the video quality wasn't exactly up to scratch in my past few videos. I was trying to figure out what to do, and I think I might just have found a solution here. Although I don't know whether it is going to make lag worse or anything, but here we go. Let's see, like, if this does make a suitable change. Anyway, let's head over into the briefing then.
With Daniil unable to communicate with its outposts, the Ranger and SEAL missions were a success. Intel from the Ranger's mission reports that the stolen viral package has been split up into smaller shipments. One of these is being held 60 kilometers east of the town of Soroti at a site designated Objective Mamba. Bravo will locate the package at Objective Mamba and secure the immediate area in preparation for the arrival of a CDC recovery team. Alpha and Charlie teams will escort the team and provide security for the retrieval operation. It is important that you do not open the package. Without proper handling, the virus could be released and decimate the local population.
Well, that is true. I mean, I suppose it is something that might as well be said. So I suppose this is where we infiltrate, and we will of course be alone. There are a few enemies along our path, but I suppose they're just patrols. I'm glad to see that most of them are down there though, and I would have the high ground for the most part. Yeah, I suppose that's as simple as it gets. Sniper rifle. Now, instead of the sniper, I would rather prefer to switch over to the 50 cal, because, well, faster rate of fire. And a law for whatever reason, I wonder. I wonder what I would need a law for. Well, in case there's a helicopter, I suppose. I didn't really see one on the screen. Yeah, I can't really see a helicopter of sorts, but okay, let's go with the 50 cal, and yeah, let's start this mission.
Bravo, this is King 6, recon the target.
King 6, this is Black Widow, en route to LZ.
This is King 6, chopper inbound from the north.
Roger that, King 6.
That guy's also dead. Now then. Is there anybody up there? Yes, there is.
King 6, this is Black Widow. We are in position.
This is King 6. You have a second chopper inbound from the northwest.
Roger, King 6. On station and standing by.
Hold it just a moment. Pause, right. And it is at this moment that I, well, essentially, well, fucked up, if I may say so, myself, because, well, I forgot to hit unmute. So this part of the game is essentially a post-gameplay recording, and, yeah, well, as things turn out, this run-through went pretty well, but I forgot to do a voiceover. I forgot to commentate on it, because, well, I was commentating on it, but the recording did not catch up. Or rather pick up, because I was on mute. As you can see the lag spikes are still another persistent problem. I'm still figuring out what to do with them. But at least from what I can tell during the video, you know, editing section, the graphics are better. Like, at least things seem a little sharper. So I suppose that's a win. Apart from that, I can't really, you know, say much. This game doesn't exactly look the best, to be honest. So we're trying to hit those guys over there, and yeah, we're essentially trying to just shoot those guys out. I'm trying to figure out where we're getting shot from this time around, and we're essentially trying to clear this area of enemies before we head on. And there are some guys here that we will now try to get rid of. Or maybe we won't. Let's see. I've actually forgotten what I do in this mission. It's been a few tries since I played it, and we see a tracer round being fired at us, and we kill the guy and the tree behind it. The 50 BMG is no joke. It is no joke. I think we see some more people coming over the ridge behind us. Just a few. But yeah, for now we're just gonna wait for the lag to go away. The lag goes away, and you're back at it. The way that this game has been designed is that it's pretty difficult. I mean, it's difficult to see the enemy. The game is not difficult by design, just the various factors that affect the gameplay make it difficult. For example, you know, the lag, and the fact that it's difficult to see the enemies, the fact that the enemies will almost always invariably win a quick draw challenge against you. So I suppose therein lies a fact about flanking them tactically, but then again, I mean, if you're playing it naturally, like you would be clearing out a room in real life, you're not going to succeed with this game. You need to rely on the information provided to you by the map and the path suggested to you by the optimal route, or like the route you're supposed to follow, all the checkpoints that you're supposed to go through. Not that they actually matter, because there are no checkpoints in this game. Another enemy that we almost no-scoped, almost. Then we did successfully no-scope them, but that was on the second try, so I wouldn't really count that. Yeah, another reason that we're using the 50 BMG in this level instead of, well, the sniper rifle that was provided with us by default is the fact that not only does that rifle take more time to reload, the effective range is also lesser in that rifle. And with the 50 BMG, you can actually get two first, like you shoot one person and you can actually just kill two at a time. That's not really possible with the, like in this instance here, that's not really possible with the sniper. Just a moment there. Yeah, apparently somebody came for some sort of delivery and my dog just went ballistic. Anyway, so yeah, back to recording a voiceover for this part. There are still like some people behind sand barricades in this section here, and I'm just waiting for my lag to die down before I'm essentially kill them. Now, one of the things that I dislike is how every single time that I zoom in using my scope, there's like the slightest bit of lag which causes me to miss my shot, and this is something that has happened in this level quite a lot. I'm unable to hit most of my shots because of the fact that the game just lags ever so slightly, even though the FPS don't really drop. It's more of a software lag, I suppose. So this village that we're looking at right now, that's empty. There's nobody in there at all. But our objective is the village right next to it, and we shall be taking the more cautious approach to get there. First off, of course, we need to get rid of those vehicles there. And let's see what happens. I forgot whether this was the successful run or not. I think this was the successful run. I think this was. But if it's not, then I probably wasted my time recording this voiceover, didn't I? Yeah, I'm searching for, like, there's supposed to be another person over there that I'm searching for, but I won't find them yet. I'll find them once I start getting down. We take that guy out. Okay, second shot. Yep. poor guy got shot in his butt. Still trying to figure out where the rest of the enemies are. It's like, once the enemy reveals his position by firing at you or you notice them, then they'll be marked on the map. But short of that, they will not be marked on the map. And those are our friends over there, just hovering in the sky. I suppose they're playing it safe by keeping the CDC scientist safe, but yeah. didn't really need to hang us out to try, to be honest. I feel like they could have helped us out a little better as well. And the guy did. We essentially just need to neutralize all the people in this village, otherwise getting to the kit is difficult. Now, I was talking about how the stealth in this game seems to have been implemented, but that is not really the case. Droning makes you more difficult, makes you less visible. The ghillie suit helps a little, but the stealth in this game is essentially programmed. The stealth that we have observed thus far is essentially just programmed stealth. It's we're not actually being stealthy, but more or less the game is just giving us the illusion that we're stealthy, is something that I realized. So yeah, there are enemies inside of that barn there, and inside of both the buildings that we need to neutralize, so I'm just gonna take it cautious for the next few minutes there. Keep checking out those buildings, and hopefully we'll find the enemies that we're looking for. So that's gonna be my play here. I'm gonna keep descending slowly, keep finding angles on the enemies up to the point where I can shoot them. I'm referring to the map again and again just to check if there are any stragglers left around that I need to kill. Thus far I can't find any, except for just the people inside of the spawn. There is, however, one other person. I don't know where that person is though. Still looking, still no sign of the enemy. I will get to the enemy shortly. Now, one of the reasons that I'm having to do... Oh yeah, I see the leg. So one of the reasons that I'm having to do this is the fact that, it's pretty difficult to actually find enemies in this game to begin with, and they have got like a far easier time seeing you. I wonder if it would have been easier if I was playing this game on like a CRT monitor, the kind of monitor that we had back in the day. But it's difficult to tell even whether it would be easy. And these guys, I've got no idea where these guys came from. Like I said, the game doesn't always mark the enemies on the map for you. Good thing I had the 50 cal, otherwise I would not have been able to shoot that guy through the tree. But like I said, good thing I had the 50 cal. So there are more enemies on the map. We just haven't found them yet, and somebody's shooting at us from across the valley. We actually can't see him. We saw the tracer there, and that's how we know that that's the enemy. But we missed the first shot because we got lag. I had dragged my mouse up, but that never got input. As you can see, we're running at 1 FPS. Now that we got some frames back, we decided to shoot and kill him in a better fashion. And while the terrain does look gorgeous for a game from 1999, I don't really think using voxels just to make the game look better should come at... That's another person there. Should come at the price of essentially playing this game safely. Like, there are a lot of performance-based issues and other optimization issues that stem from using the voxel-based map generation that this game follows, because everything else looks pixelated except for the map. The map looks absolutely impeccable, and but that's just about it. The map just looks beautiful. A lot of the times things on it keep on disappearing, and it's difficult to differentiate between an enemy and something like a dead enemy, like a prone enemy and a dead enemy, or a, you know, or something like a bush or even like a tree in the distance. And this is something that the game has carried on since Delta Force 1. So, yeah, it's nothing new as far as Delta Force 2 is concerned, but it still is a hassle. I never would have thought that my PC would be lagging while trying to play a game from 1999, considering that the hardware that I'm using right now was King during 2010-2011, that era. Or maybe even after that, I do believe. I'm not certain. I think the King back then was the GTX 750, 760 series. This is the 1050, I think. This was like the King 10 years ago, back in 2012 or 2013, 14-ish, around that time. So yeah, again, I'm not really an expert on the topic. I'm not a historian, so I'll just take what I say with a pinch of salt and consider them to be round figures. Now, while the CDC is in charge of essentially getting rid of the, you know, taking care of the virus, the briefcase containing the virus samples, we need to locate it first, which is something that the briefing had not told me. So, which is something that I had no idea of. So, I just coincidentally walk into the first building and, like, find a sample of viruses in there, which you guys will notice in just a while. By the time I finish with my antics of being cautious and approaching this building cautiously, because despite the amount of caution that I'm exercising, it says approaching objective Mamba right now, as you can see in the top left corner. Now, despite the caution that I'm exercising in approaching this building, I don't really see the enemies until, like, the very last moment. And I'm ultimately thankful that that's the virus container right there. And ultimately, I am thankful that I do see the enemies in this, you know, hut. It was difficult to spot them in the first place as well. So, right after we have located the virus samples, Charlie and Alpha decide to swoop in, and we just have to extract, and that's it. But extracting is also, you know, pretty difficult in this game. We need to be a little cautious while doing that. That's one person down. And there's another enemy inside of the same building. And we're just trying to figure out where that enemy is right now. He's actually in the far right corner, crouching behind a table, using the table as cover. Poor soul does not know that we have an anti-materiel rifle, which is going to blow right through it and through him. So, yeah. I don't know why they tell us to get rid of those 4x4s, but I suppose King 6 is just trying to be cautious as well. So, yeah, that was some amateur CS level pixel peeking, but if it works, sending it works. And we have located the virus. We simply extract right now. Maybe I should switch over to a different audio channel so that I can actually hear what the game sounds like. I've been using the microphone recording channel right now, which says nothing, which is like just a bunch of empty noise. So I think yeah, I should have done this before probably, because I'm probably speaking over the game right now. But well, it is what it is. It is what it is. I'm feeling too lazy to record this all over again, so we're just gonna roll with this. And right now what I'm trying to do is trying to keep my distance from these buildings, and in case I see an enemy, of course I will shoot them. But the reason that I want to keep distance is because distance in this game is the only thing that nullifies losing a quick draw contest. You will never be as fast as the enemy when it comes to drawing a gun, or shooting for that matter. Got one. There's another one in that same building, but yeah, that one we've got. There's also another one in that barn, but we, for whatever reason, could never really identify them. That's one of our choppers. I think that's the one in which we extract, and Charlie and Alpha teams have their own choppers. Now, I wonder why we are always Bravo and never Alpha or Charlie. I wonder why they chose us to be Bravo, but maybe they wanted to say, Bravo, good job. Anyway, that's just my conjecture. Anyhow, our helos are almost at the extraction, and we should be there too. So that's where we're headed. There's another guy that shot at us, and we're trying to essentially steer clear of that person. Now, the thing is, Alpha and Charlie get down and they begin taking care of the hostiles as well. So, yeah, I mean, being a part of the Delta Force, I think they're pretty proficient at taking out at least two bad guys. So, considering the fact that there are four of them, although that was a pretty tall order for them in Delta Force 1, they seem to be more proficient at it in Delta Force 2. Especially in the previous mission. Mission, what was it again? Blindside? Yeah, I mean, in Mission Blindside, these guys literally walked up to an enemy and just stabbed him with a knife. Stabbed him to death. And those are the CDC scientists in white that you can see. completely covered with hazmat suits. And we heard the sounds of a bad guy dying, and yeah, Alpha 1 and 2 are apparently now actively neutralizing, or rather trying to neutralize the enemy in the barn, but, well, that guy's a little too dumb. Like, those guys are a little too dumb, they're shooting at their own helicopter. Good thing that bullets can't destroy vehicles in this game. Which is something that I find strange, to be honest. I mean, it is realistic, but... also very limiting when it comes to this game. The fact that you cannot shoot and blow up vehicles anymore. But at any rate, that is it for today's video. Operation Special Delivery. The only remaining mission right now is Operation Power Trip. It has not unlocked anything new. So when we come back, we will be covering Operation Power Trip. For this mission, Special Delivery, this was it. Thank you for tuning in, thank you for watching, and thank you for sticking around to the end. Until next time, take care. Fare thee well, fellow things.